Now what we are going to do, if again whatever we are discussing is true for n dimensional world or a good populated with n different goods, but I am going to describe a world which has only two goods. So here basically what we have, x 1 is a function of p 1, p 2 and I, and x 2 is a function of, again not necessarily the same function, that is why here x 1 and x 2 these are different, x 2 is again a function of p 1, p 2 and I. So what we are going to do, we are going to study the effect of, let us say, we will do it only for good 1, of course good 2 will become clear to you, that we are going to study the effect of change in I on x 1, then we are going to study the effect of change in p 1 on x 1, and then also we are going to discuss the effect of change in p 2 on x 1. Okay, three things we are going to discuss, fine. Okay, so the first thing first, let us start with the income, the effect of change in income on the quantity demanded of good 1,
effect of income on quantity demanded for good 1, this is what we are going to describe.
Of course, you should know this quantity demanded, how a consumer is buying any of these goods, depending on his optimization problem. He has certain test, he has certain preference that we have translated into utility function and indifference curves, and he has some budget constraints, and based on these two he figures out that how much at the to maximize his utility, to get the maximum level of satisfaction, how much of good 1 he should consume, and that optimal level is his quantity demanded for good 1, it is not just any quantity demanded. So let us take an example, rather than doing a general case, let us take an example. What we will do, we will take a specific kind of utility function, and this is probably the most important utility function, because you will encounter it again and again in the economic theory, and that utility function is, the type is called Cobb-Douglas function. Again we are talking about two good world, x 1 and x 2, you maximize it with respect to x 1 and x 2, such that p 1 x 1 plus p 2 x 2 should be less than or equal to I. Okay? If you solve it, remember a similar problem we have solved in the class, what was that problem? We had solved log x plus log y, we had solved. Here of course log x is x 1 and log y it is log of x 2. Okay? Just look at it, look at this problem, we know that form the optimal level of consumption of good 1 and good 2 does not depend on the form, it depends on the preference, that we have already talked about it. So if we take any monotonic transformation, okay, that would also work to get the optimal level of x 1 and x 2. So let us take monotonic transformation, log is of course, if we take log of this function, we will get the monotonic transformation of this particular function, and what we will get? A log, or let me write it step by step, this is going to be x 1 a, x 2 b, and here it is multiplication, so what we can write it? We can write log x 1 a plus log x 2 b, okay? This is property of log, and then this can be written as log x 1 plus b log x 2. Now I consider you sufficiently familiar with this technique, so I am not going to solve it completely, but if you solve it, what you will get? X 1 star is equal to a I divided by b 1, and x 2 star is equal to b I divided by p 1, p 2, thank you, b I divided by p 2, So, what is happening here? Let us look in the graph. If you draw the Cobb-Douglas, it will look like this. Okay. Now, let us say what we have here is, this is the budget line, touching it here, of course, my poor drawing. And then what we have here is, this is the next budget line. How did we get the other budget line? Here, let us say this is P1 x1 plus P2 x2 is equal to I1. Now, what has happened here? These two lines are parallel. Okay? So, what we are doing? We are keeping P1 and P2 fixed, because what we are interested in? We are interested in the effect of change in income on quantity demanded for good one. So, now we are changing it to I2, and when we change it to I2, what happens? There is a parallel shift in the budget line, and that is what we get. And similarly, let me draw it just like this, touching, and then this is the third and this is the fourth. Okay? These are parallel to each other. And of course, all the optimal bundle lies on, bundles lie on this line. That I know. How do I know?
By getting tangency points.
By getting the tangency points. Okay.
If we are putting P1 constant, then X1 is A, I1. So, it is a linear function in I and A. Linear function in I. So, if we increase the income, it would be a linear transition.
It is linear. It will be linearly increasing. So, what we are getting? This path, basically this line, which passes through all the optimal bundles when income is increased or decreased, or in other word, when income is varied, is called income expansion path. And of course, income expansion path is drawn on graph giving the indifference map. Okay? So, what is important we are drawing? Remember, for income expansion path, we are drawing the indifference curve and we are finding the optimal bundles. And when then we are drawing a curve that passes through all the optimal bundles, that curve is called income expansion path. Okay? Or income consumption curve, fine, or income consumption path. Okay? Fine. In other word, it is very much possible that we have this kind of, this is the indifference map, and then let me draw the budget line. What we have here is, so, it is like it is going like this, not necessarily it is a straight line. Okay? This is the curve giving all the optimal bundles. So, this is, this curve is called income
consumption
path. Fine? If I look at it, I can say there are two possibilities at any level, that let us say when income goes up, either it goes up, x1 star goes up. Okay? Let me write it here, that what is happening? Income is going up and dx1 star di is positive. It, what does it mean? That when income increases, the consumption of good one at the optimal level increases. So, in this case, we call these goods, this
normal
good is
normal good.
Okay? And when it leads to decrease in consumption of good one,
inferior,
then it is called inferior good. At some places, normal good is given name of superior good, but we will stick to these names, normal good and inferior good. Fine? Is it clear? So now what can we do, that rather than drawing this curve, let us look at the definition first for a moment. Okay? That just what we understood about income expansion path, that income expansion path of a consumer is a curve on his indifference map. This is very important, that this curve is represented on indifference map. On indifference map that traces all his optimal consumption, that traces all his optimal consumption bundles for his different levels of income, while the prices of all goods in the economy are held constant. Fine? Okay. So, what I am trying to say, that you should not forget this term, that this curve is traced on his indifference map. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to trace these optimal, this is the component of optimal bundle on different curve. What we have here is, let us say that x axis gives us the optimal level of consumption of good one, on y axis we have income. Okay? So, what we are taking, let us look at it, that this here, this is x 1 star. This x 1 star corresponds to a particular level of income. So, we can figure out that how much is x 1 star and how much is the income. Corresponding income, and we plot it here. Okay? And similarly for all the optimal bundles, what we plot? X 1 star and respective I, and then we will plot, depending on the different problem we plot, it will look like this. Okay? It can be any curve, and then we can, of course, if we take more curve, more optimal bundles, we will have better
continuous curve.
Okay? Fine? And this curve is called Engel's curve. Now, let us look at it on Engel's curve. If Engel's curve is like, let us say this, there is a possibility that consumption of good one increases as income increases up to certain level, and that is till this point, and then it starts decreasing. What does it mean? It simply means that in this zone, this good is normal good. And in this zone, it is inferior good. Fine? Is it clear? Okay. Now, let us take one or two examples. We have obtained the expression of x 1 star in terms of p 1 and p 2 and I earlier. Let us try to draw the Engel curve for those particular cases. So, let us take one case of quasi-linear utility. What did we say? That quasi-linear utility will be of this form, v x plus y, where it is linear in y, and v x, where of course we should put some assumption here that v dash is increasing in x, but the rate of increase is decreasing as x is increasing. What it means is that any fixed label of y, if we change x, the utility will increase, but at decreasing rate. Okay? Fine. Can you tell me what will be the income expansion path? We had taken a special case where Vx was log function. Okay? What we had, I do not remember exactly, but we had something like a log x plus by, something like this we had. So, can you tell me what will be the income expansion path for x? Remember, we had solved it that first it linearly increases in income, okay? Because what happens that up to certain level this person spends his income only for good one. So, up to that level x 1 star is basically I by P 1, a function of I by P 1, okay? Fine. So, it is linearly increasing, and after a certain level is reached,
he
does not buy any more of good one. So, it becomes independent of income. So, it will be like this. So, angle curve looks like this. How about for good 2?
First 0 till
up to certain level, it will be 0. Let me use this color. So, it is like this. 0, and then it starts increasing linearly. Fine? Is it clear? Okay. So, now we have studied the effect of change in income on quantity demanded. Of course, we have done it for only good 1. We can do it for good 2 also. Let us look at Cobb-Douglas function. What happens in for the Cobb-Douglas function? It is linearly increasing. So, this will be the Engels curve, Cobb-Douglas. Fine.